He was a typical child. He was he'd sleep and cooperate. He was a good one. A couple of years later, I came along. It's okay though, because you know, while Mum was busy with me, Mum bought him a doll, a little baby, a little doll. So, while Mum was changing my nappy, Tim would, of course, be changing his doll's nappy. When Tim was ironing, when Mum was all ironing our clothes, Tim was ironing his little one's clothes. When Mum was breastfeeding me, Tim was there offering up his four famous little nipples. Tim absolutely loves celebrations. He really is mental for it. Christmas specifically, the guy is he's 33 years old and he's the most excited in the room. I've got a 2-year-old. And he's still the most excited in the house. I remember, starting with dolls. Tim was always there. Tim always had a taste for the feminine toys from the beginning, with the dolls and the Care Bears and the My Little Ponies. Yeah, he was a fan of those. More recently, he's got himself an HTC phone, of course. Feminine toys. Yeah. It's interesting how he turned out, though. I mean, while always sort of smart and clued up, he didn't really have an awful lot of time for academia. He didn't get along too well at all. In fact, he did well and he achieved well. He got his GCSEs, but he never really did all that he could have possibly done. Actually, he sort of came home, and as he said in his ramble, he'd come home and instead of doing the same work, he'd work on one of the 7 little simulator businesses. So he ran pizza restaurants and theme parks and cities and Grand Prix. The man is mental for it. he and Stev would just literally spend whole summer holidays in there running businesses. In fairness, I've got a list and we're going to talk about some of the businesses he did. I was writing and sort of practicing the speech when I was on holiday a couple of weeks ago in Turkey, and my wife, Jembo, actually came out with while we were talking about business, and I sort of came out one after the other of these things that's in harebrained schemes you describe them as, and I think that's fair. And she sort of goes, "A lot of Muslim women here. I bet it gets hot under those rocks. What if we designed a fan that we could attach to their knees? Add a bit of circulation under their foot."
Amazing.
Amazing. We could call it the fan knee. Now, Tim's idea is really selling fans to Muslims. Just a few examples to help introduce some ushers. Sam. Sammy on the end, the mule. Sam was Tim's earliest best friend, as Tim mentioned in his speech. You know, they hold the flying frame and made it very, very clear that nobody was to go on it. So, you know, to start off with, it was some low-level racketeering as a starting point at nursery. But it is their close relationship, interestingly, that has forged such a close relationship between our families. And our family are like links with the quirks. That's actually great. Woohoo! Then we've got Stev. Here he is. Stev's a really close friend. Lives near enough opposite us at home. And he was actually involved in one of Tim's first businesses. After the racketeering, Tim moved on and sort of switched sides, and he started the Ravenstone School. made the same school. I vividly remember cutting in a hedge in the summer holidays with a pair of hedge trimmers sculpting out my classroom. It's all right. Wasn't on my own. Steph was there. Getting ready to teach. Same environment that learning can happen.
I thought she was a dinner lady.
And then Timmy, the headmaster, of course. Now, Tim later went into marketing, and it's no surprise that when he put together a pack of information for this, the Ravenstone School, and he distributed it to the parents of the village, we actually got inquiries. Hi there. Brilliant. Is it Tim there? I want to talk to you about enrolling my child into the bush on Bay Lane. Run by the 3 8-year-olds. Now that's marketing. And of course, James. One half of Sweetness and Light. Yay! The golfing team they struck up to take on the work. To be more specific, the shit golfing team they struck up to take on the mighty Dagwood. Woo! While at school, Tim and James they had a couple of money making enterprises. First one to demonstrate their God-given talent to music. God-given guy. Make a bit of money. They decided to start a band. Those who know Tim, even a little bit, know Tim can't do anything. Tim couldn't then either. Mum came to him and said, you know, she found him on the phone to venues around Bedford. In her most supportive manner. What are you doing, Tim? You can't play any instruments, even the most basic standards. To which Tim replies intelligently, well, if I can't get any gigs, it's not really worth me bothering, is it? I'm not a learning instrument. And if I can, well, it's an incentive to practice. He also, while at school, set up a business creating illegal ID cards that allowed his classmates to get into the local pubs and clubs. That's right. That's until the police came. He gave him a rap on the wrist for breaking the law. Got down here, breaking the law. Now, there are several of us in the room who are quite worried about Tim, from about pretty much anyone who knew him from the age of about 12 to 21. It really raises questions when you're such a lovely guy, you've got the Edward's good looks. Yay! A bit sarcastic. Woo! A little bit sarcastic when there's only one person doing it. Woo! Again, only one. He couldn't find himself a girl. He was looking high and low. But then again, there was a period on the 22nd of August 1998. Tim's 18th birthday.
Oh dear God.
A charming lady arrived at Tayfort Place. And if you were in our living room, you would agree they did seem to be getting on pretty well. Here she is.
Oh my God.
And no, not a good enough look. It's all right. Let me answer the questions on your lips. Yes, they are pissed. Both pissed. So, while Mum was out buying a new hat, thinking that she had a daughter-in-law, Tim?
Yes.
Tim was stripped to his pants in record time on all four, being thankful for his work. Later, if that's true.
So the lad was searching high and low.
True. Clearly. In fairness, he went to bed from school for boys. Sweet. I don't know which one to leave on. Such charmers.
That one.
The lad was searching high and low. In fairness, he went to bed from modern school for boys, so he surrounded himself with lads. Which makes it slightly difficult. So alright, he went to school on the school bus with loads of girls. And he led the back row, as far as I can understand, I wasn't there, but through hymns. Religious hymns sung at the top of his voice. So needless to say, not an awful lot of luck here either. Before Tim began studying at Surrey University, he went travelling around the world. He needed to find somewhere in the world that he had his place. He needed to surround himself with boys, and he needed somewhere he could belt out those hymns. Salvation Army of boys, isn't it? Nail on the head, sign me up. So he did. These boys were specifically disadvantaged, and he went out there for and did a bit of travelling afterwards as well. And I went to visit him in Malaysia, and he had found himself a girl to hang off his arm. I think that was Brenda. And knowing the relative proximity to Bangkok and their infamous chick boys, I did all the checks that you as a younger brother you do. I didn't take it too far, but in all fairness, I don't think Tim did either. She was a Mormon. When Tim arrived home, he found himself in a barren, featureless desert once more. I understand there was a time he was considering taking up tennis to explain the variation in his bicep. I didn't think it was that bad, actually. It looks worse in the picture. Then in 2008, he met his beautiful wife, Holly. It took the characteristic long time to meet her, to actually be invited out. But when we did, we were absolutely chuffed. Really, 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 really happy. Such an excellent girl and such a really cool couple. For the two of you to be getting married for better or for worse, it's ironic, isn't it? Because really, Tim, you couldn't have done any better. You really couldn't have done any worse. Now, I'm not sure, I'm sure we all have a few questions about about this. So I've put together a short reel that should help us all out answering these, and we'll see if we can get anywhere with it.
Telling. Virtual. I'm going to be saucy. A little bit of sauce. Boobs. She's got nice boobs. She's got a nice ass as well. She's hot.
How very deep and thoughtful. Are you sure there's nothing else?
I don't know. God, I love them boobs. I don't know. Pass. Sorry.
What do you think she gets out of it?
Always being right. It's an annoying habit of mine. I'm picking my nose a bit. I don't know.
How the hell did you get her?
I mean, I tried some pretty exciting moves on the dance floor on the Wednesday night in St. Anton with a pole and pole dancing around it, and eventually made myself sick. That was the first night that I knew she liked me.
Yeah, probably the move.
What
are you doing? Quite a show. So, you must see, I was not always easy for me to have a sibling that's held in such high regard. Imagine being compared to someone so smart and funny and talented and great at everything. I truly don't think I'd be the man I am today if I didn't have someone of this calibre to look up to. For that, I'd like to thank my little sister Helen. What I've, like I said, at my wedding, Tim kidnapped the bride. I wanted a big ending. So on your table, I've actually put a song, I've parodied a song for today. So for the second time today, I'm going to ask you to sing along with me.
Yeah, now, baby.
You'll have to actually do it, because otherwise it really is going to be just crap. All together.